And we are back with a brand new video. I wanted to discuss the Fighting Demons album that just dropped from Juice, along with Legends Never Die. I also want to take this video to discuss my opinions on, you know, all the Juice music that has dropped in the last couple of years. But this isn't the only Juice video I've dropped this week. I did an album reaction. I also did a tier list as well. So go ahead and check those out. So right away, I'll say like my top three from each album. So from Fighting Demons, has to be Burn, Not Enough, Feel Alone. Top three from Legends Never Die has to be Blood on My Jeans, Conversations, and then Man of the Year. Each album has a ton of standout songs, somewhere around like 11 each. Both also had a ton of leaks on the track list. Now, I don't really listen to a ton of leaks. You know, I listen to some. Fighting Demons did not even get spoiled for me. I'd never heard any of those. And for Legends Never Die, I only listened to a couple. For instance, Wishing Well, I knew that song before it even came out. Fighting Demons' track list is 18 songs, but that has 3 skits in it. Legends Never Die is 22 songs, but has 4 skits in it. And both of the track lists are majority sad songs from Juice, but they also each have a handful of more upbeat songs or more mainstream songs in them. But Legends Never Die was more of a mainstream album because it was his first posthumous album. And that album did have more hits. If you remember last year, Wishing Well, Come and Go, those were all over the radio, ESPN, that type of stuff. For Fighting Demons, the official sales aren't out yet because it hasn't been a full week, but it is going to debut number 2 because Adele is still like on her 4th week selling more than Juice. It's going to be 125k, somewhere around there. It might be a little higher, might be a little lower, but still, I would have thought it would have been a little higher. I mean, I knew it wasn't going to be anything like Legends Never Die, which was 500k. Take out like half of that from the merch bundles, which they don't count anymore, but Legends Never Die sales was still like 250. So the hype for Fighting Demons definitely was not as much there, but I still thought, you know, the album was gonna do like 180k at least. But when it comes to the fan favorite stuff, the fans definitely were happier with Fighting Demons. A lot more people like that album more. If you take in the release dates even to the hype of the album, I only streamed half of what I streamed Juice WRLD last year. So in general, I was just listening to Juice a lot more, along with when it actually dropped. It was a summer album for Legends Never Die compared to a December album for Fighting Demons, being in late 2021. I think the timing of the releases as well plays a factor in how much I enjoy these albums. And the hype for the new project from Juice when it came out, you know, playing all these songs, is definitely less, and I can tell that compared to the release of Legends Never Die, I guess, was a lot more special and memorable. To touch on production, Fighting Demons was a lot more eerie or dark, kind of. A lot of emo rap stuff. There was questionable mixing on a couple songs, but nothing that bothered me, nothing that I'm complaining about, but it definitely wasn't as clean as Legends Never Die. I think in Legends Never Die, they made the songs definitely a lot more beautiful, cleaner sounding. I absolutely did not mind the kind of violin breakdown type of stuff they added on like half the songs. I think they overall made it more cohesive on Legends Never Die. And I do think from top to bottom, it is easier to listen to Legends Never Die. Now, going back to the release dates real quick, when I listened to the first posthumous album from Juice, like half a year from when he had passed, the album just hits more. And by the time we get into late 2021, where we are now in current time, and you're listening to Juice, my music taste has changed. I got older. I found other artists. I found a love for Trippie Redd this year, a crazy amount, and I played him more than Juice this year. Juice is still my favorite artist, but I know years down the line that one day he's not going to be, and that's just how it is. Like, it's just naturally gonna happen. for the features on each album, they each, you know, had a handful, nothing over the top that, you know, looked like they're milking the album. Fighting Demons, I think they did a great job. They put on Justin Bieber on there. You had guys like Polo G were on both albums who did a solid job, I would say, on each album. Trippie Redd was on both albums. I think he absolutely killed it on Fighting Demons. I like his performance more than the hook on Tell Me You Love Me. And then for Fighting Demons, the last feature had was BTS. It came in, absolutely killed it. Juice already made a song with him back in 2019, and that song's doing really good. Super beautiful track. Legends Never Died had a couple more features. It, you know, also had Halsey at the end of a song, Marshmello on a couple productions, but that's not like a crazy feature, just because Marshmello is a producer. And then you can't forget about The Weeknd, who was added on. Kind of another controversial one about that song dropping, but we can get into it later. We can quickly even just talk about the cover arts. They're somewhat similar in a way where it is like a picture of Juice in the middle somewhere with a really cool background going on. Breaking down each album, getting a ton of hours listening to each of them, you know, having them both out now, it's really close. It's hard to pick a favorite here. I think at the end of the day, I right now making this video, I think Legend Never Dies better. You know, both albums have, you know, big hit songs on them, a lot of great moments. Actually listening to the album, sitting through it top to bottom, Legend Never Die is the better experience. By the way, both of these albums are no skips. Filler or worse songs on Legends Never Die are way better than some of the ones on Fighting Demons, where Fighting Demons has maybe a couple of the worst released Juice songs. But let me know in the comments down below which one you think better. I think the diehard fans are gonna say Fighting Demons, but I have to disagree. Again, really, really close, but I wanna know what you guys think in the comments down below. Both albums were used to honor Juice and to spread a positive message that he wanted to spread. So I think both projects were absolutely incredible, 10 out of 10. I guess another point that I wanted to make here at the end of the video is I see a lot of people saying that, you know, how much longer will Juice's career go on for? It can't go on forever. I know how many unreleased songs he has. As a fan, you know, part of me wants to be like, oh yeah, we can just make, you know, one album a year for the next decade, you know, that'd be great. But also part of me is like, you know, we do gotta wrap this up soon. It can't go on forever, and that's just how it is. Over time, the hype's gonna go down. You gotta remember the music is stuck in 2018, 2019, every single time. There's no new songs being made, obviously. The Party Never Ends. You know, if they ever did a collab tape, if that's even possible, you know, I'd be down for a Young Thug collab tape. There's still The Outsiders, which I kind of hope is like the last project or something, or there's Into the Abyss that could be like a project, or Naruto Date in London, like just all love songs, that'd be fire. 2 to 3 albums, we gotta wrap it up, if I gotta be honest. We know we have a deluxe possibly in March. We know we have The Party Never Ends in 2022 in the month of June. So if you guys enjoyed the content, make sure you guys are subscribed to the channel with notifications on. And yeah, give me to 500 subs, please. I got a ton of banger videos coming out at the end of the year. You don't want to miss all my end of the year list videos. I got some crazy like award show stuff I'm working on. Crazy videos. So yeah, stay tuned on the channel. Thank you all for watching. Peace out.